Hey, I'm Gary Bryan. I do a morning radio show in Los Angeles. I met Vince Ciacci in 2015. A friend of mine said they knew a celebrity barber in Brentwood, which is a ritzy suburb of L.A., and I thought, well, okay, a celebrity barber. And then they said, oh, did I mention that he was in the Mafia? And he's got great stories. You got to meet this guy. So I went to my friend's conference room, and I met Vince Ciacci, and he immediately launched into his life story, his troubled relationship with his parents, the bullying he endured as a kid, and then the day that everything in his life changed, the day he snapped and beat the hell out of a much bigger kid. So in about 5 minutes, I knew this guy was an amazing storyteller with an amazing story to tell. This is a true crime story unlike any other, a story of violence, degradation, drugs, alcohol, sex, and more. But unlike most true crime stories, this one ends in redemption. How he got there is a hell of a journey. You're going to hear about the Coxsackie Reformatory in upstate New York, where the young guys were split into warring factions, enduring brutal abuse from the guards. When Vince wound up on the kitchen crew, he faced a challenge and a crisis that could have ended his life. After Coxsackie, he spent 10 years on the streets of New York, drunk, high, violent. In fact, so violent that his own crew wanted to kill him. He was doing scores for made guys. But he never became a wise guy. He never got made in the Mafia because he was too out of control. After 10 years of absolute chaos and violence on the streets of New York, he moved to California to try to change his life and wound up right back at the same place. Only this time he was running with some of the worst guys on the West Coast and dealing heroin and cocaine and finally wound up almost killing himself in a car accident with drugs and guns in the rocker panels of the car. But through all of this, he never got caught. The chance of him being alive today are about zero. But he's here, and he's here to tell the tale. And at the end of the tale, you'll hear his story of redemption. As a matter of fact, Vince has helped hundreds of people since he beat his own drug and alcohol addiction. I think you're going to get a lot out of this story. I know I did. So enjoy Mobshot, My Life in the Mafia, with Vince Ciacci.
So I'm in my cell that night, and I'm looking out at the yard, and I see everybody in the yard. And I'm going, Jesus Christ, look at all these fucking people. And all of a sudden, I see a bunch of guys running towards this wall where all these black guys are. And they start fucking fighting, about 40 guys. Boom, boom, boom. The guards coming off the porches. And I said, what the fuck am I, what am I getting into here?
Vince Ciacci, Mobshot, My Life and the Mafia, Part 1.
Yeah, hi, my name is Vince Ciacci, and I wanted to be a wise guy. A wise guy is a made guy in the mob, and I was a drinker and a drugger, and I got in a lot of trouble for that, so that actually kept me from being made in a wise guy, you know, and thank God I didn't get made, because once you're in, you don't get out. This is my life story, and it's quite a tale. There is a God, because there were some incidents in my story that I should have been dead or put in jail, and came close to it many times. It all started with a fight in the park, and all of a sudden I wanted to be a tough guy, because I saw it got respect, and I ran with that. And we were committing a lot of crimes, me and these young kids, and I was in a gang and everything. I was a real rowdy guy, and wound up, I got busted on a robbery, and this time they wanted to send me away. I thought I was going to go home, but the funny story is I had this probation officer, and everything I did with him was wrong. He came up to the house one time. He caught me in bed with my girlfriend, and I just had a bad attitude with him. And, you know, stupid, because his report actually was responsible for me to go away. So I went before the judge downtown at the courts, 100 Center Street. Before I went to court, I was trying to figure out how am I going to, because I had a feeling I was going to go away, because I got arrested for minor stuff, but, you know. So I figured I'm going to join the Marine Corps. That'll do it. That'll get me out of going to jail, right? So I go.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.